Hello friends, hope you are doing well. So today we will talk about the FMG exam. FMG is a foreign medical graduate entrance examination. So this exam will give you a license to practice as a doctor in India, and this is also a gateway for starting your internship. So now as the dates are out, exam is in December. So I will tell you how to attempt a paper and what should be your mindset when you are attempting an exam and attempting an FMG question paper. So I have made a small presentation where I'll be discussing about how to categorize your questions, how to divide your time, and those who are giving the exam for the first time. So I'll give you the view that how the interface appears, how we are going to write this exam. So exam is in December, so there are less than 2 months. I'm sure your preparations are going well. So let's find out what should be your exam strategy. Give me a moment so I can share the this presentation with you. So FMG exam, it's quite a lengthy, it's kind of marathon exam because they allow the entry. It is divided into two parts. So there will be a part one and this is a part two. So I have taken this from the information bulletin that was released by NB. So they allow entry at 7 a.m. for part one and the entry would be closed at 8:30 a.m. You will be given it is an online exam. So it will be usually taken in IT centers. There are these computer labs where these examinations happen. So whenever you will be taken through some initial process, so there will be your verification of your identity. Then there will be a biometric where your thumbprint will be taken. Your real time picture will be taken. Your admit card will be checked. Your ID card will be checked. Do not forget to take the same ID card that you have mentioned in your admit card. Also, you should reach your exam hall in time. So you should be familiar with the exam center. So usually they will close the exam entry half an hour before the exam starts. So once you are at your seat, so you will be allotted one system with the computer, keyboard and mouse. So keyboard is used only once to enter the password. Otherwise, you should not touch the keyboard. Only mouse would be useful during the whole exam. So around 8:45 a.m. you will be granted access to the exam. So they will be, you will be allotted one ID. That ID most of the time is your candidate ID, and password will be provided by them. But password will be your, there are a few numbers on your admit card. So your ID will be already there sometimes, and your password would be your candidate ID. So once you enter, then it will open and there will be one consent and there will be information about the exam. So they will tell you that there are so and so number, there are 300 questions and it carries no negative marking. And there is a small tutorial which will make you familiar with how the exam will proceed. So these instructions you can read. So you will be allotted 10 minutes time to read those instructions. So if you're writing it for the first time, you should read them carefully because these are the similar instructions you'll have in your NEET exam also. So these so I will also tell you how these instructions works. So exam will start, the part one will start at 9 and you will have around 2.5 hours to attempt first 150 questions. Then there will be a exam will end at around 11:30. The second part will start at 2 p.m. and it will finish by 4:30 p.m. Again, the similar process will happen and will be allotted around 2.5 hours for the second part also. So in total, it is a 5 hour exam and there is around 2.5 hour break in between. So trust me, you're going to be tired because it's a very lengthy exam. I don't know why they have divided it into two parts, but again, we can't do anything about it. So make sure that you have your proper breakfast. So let me start with the 1 day prior to exam. So what we always follow and what I always tell people that, you know, close your books by 7 p.m. max. Like 1 day prior to exam, don't stress yourself much. Close your books because whatever you have studied, now enough, it's time to relax. Because now your brain need a relaxation time because next day it has to perform to the best of its potential. So close your books, take a good food, talk to your friends, talk to your family, and then try to sleep early. You know what happens, why I'm telling you try to sleep early? Because there's a lot of tension and a lot of stress going through your mind, and it's very difficult to fall asleep. So try sleeping earlier, better chances that you will fall asleep. If you try sleeping late, then there is anxiety, there is a panic attacks and everything, and you won't be able to sleep at all. So if you don't rest well before exam, then you wake up tired, and it will have some impact on your, it will hamper your thinking process when you're attending a question paper. So try to sleep early, have a good food, and take a hygienic food from a good place. Because if you eat not so good food, you might have some problem, because this is going to be one of the very important day of your life. So take a good rest and check your documents one day prior to exam, that your ID card, your admit card, your ID card, and you should check your exam center, see how far it is. Also, you have to reach, they have given the entry time at 7 a.m. and entry closes at 8:30 a.m. So what happens that most of the time you're not able to get the Ola or Uber cab on time. So make sure you make the proper arrangement. You have to take care of these things also apart from your study. So check the distance, that how far and when you should start. Don't be late, because it adds extra tension when you're traveling to the exam. So you should have 30 minutes spare time, because you know anything can happen in between. So keep 30 minutes spare time when you are traveling to the exam center. So talking about the day of exam. So I told you that how you are going to log in. So once you enter in the exam hall, because they will allow you from 8 a.m. So that 1 hour you'll be sitting. So just try to relax whenever you're in that computer lab. So there is no watch. Sometimes you don't know what time it is, and it's a very torturous wait most of the times. Just relax, take a small, just close your eyes, try to meditate. You know, just try to relax, so because your brain has to perform to its level best. So I have tried to make this small interface. So once you log in and once you agree with the terms and condition and you read your instructions, so your exam will start. And there is a countdown clock that will appear on your screen that will tell you that your exam will start in next 5 or 10 minutes. So once that countdown ends, it will tell you that you can start the exam. And when you press OK, then your exam will start. The benefit of this online exam is that you will get exactly 3 hours. Even if you press, like if you're a few minutes or seconds later to press start exam, then you'll get your particular time. So this is how I'm tried my best to just to show you guys that how to replicate the kind of interface you get in the exam. So on the left, there will be the question, like most common type of seizures seen in units, and there will be 4 options, subtle, hypoxic, hypoglycemic, and hypocalcemic. So to the left side, there will be small circles where you have to click. So when you will click, there will appear a small black dot, and then that means you have attempted the question. Now you have to see on the right side of your screen. So whenever you're looking at the right time of screen, there will be a timer which will tell how much time is left. So it will be in minutes and seconds. So like for example, 60 minutes and 40 seconds left. Now there are these color coding. So you should also be aware of this color coding, because this makes things easier and it puts things into perspective. So there are 4 options given below. That is previous to go to the previous question, then next to go for the next question. Then there are 2 extra tabs which you should be aware. One is mark and one is mark for review. So for example, I feel that the answer is subtle seizures. So I will click on the subtle. So once I click on the subtle, so there appears a black mark. And when the black mark will appear on the same time, I will say, then I'll go next. So I have answered this question. So that means, and this will turn red. This will turn green, not red. Once I have answered the question, and if I am not taking, if I put next, this will appear green. Green means I have answered this question. Okay, so this box will become green. Now this question will go to second. Now let's see, I go on the second question. Now I'm not sure of the answer, but I think hypoglycemia is the answer, but I'm not sure. So what I do, I answer hypoglycemia and I mark for review. So when I do that, it will turn purple and there will be a small green circle appear at the end of it. So that means that I have answered this question, but still I'm not sure of the answer. So I would like to visit this question one more time. So this helps you navigate through the question. So you don't have to find that question again. So when you are scrolling through this line, so you can see how many questions are with purple and green combination. So you can visit those questions again and think about them one more time. So this is kind of answered and marked for review. Then there is a question which is marked for review. So you don't answer this question, but you just mark for review because you want to visit this question one more time and you are not sure about the answer. So why this is important? Why this color coding is important? Because what happens for the most of the times, the questions which are in green, they usually are considered during the evaluation. The questions which are marked purple, they are not considered for evaluation. For example, if you have checked the answer and you have clicked the answer and you are only you have not answered and only marked for review, so this will not be taken into consideration because you have not attempted it, you have not taken into it, given any answer. But if you have answered and marked for review, then that will be considered for the evaluation. But to be on the safer side, always make sure that you have answered. Don't, the question which you answer, don't mark it for review at the end. Once you again review it, just convert it into the answered question that will be given by the green color. Okay. So this is just, this color coding is just to make your navigation easier through the question paper. So red mark is the question you have not answered and the white is the question you have not yet visited. So when you will say next, you will visit the next question. So this is kind of interface you get. So once you are on the, let's say you complete in the first of 150 questions. Now you can just scroll up. Instead of going through the question paper, you can just scroll through up. So you see the first question is not answered. You might get your second question as, let's say 2, 3, 4 will be green. So that will be answered. So you don't have to go through 2, 3, 4 again. Then you get 5 as the purple with the green. So that means you have answered this question, but you want to rethink the answer. So you'll go there and you again, okay, I want to change my answer. So that's what is used. So purple color are the questions which you have marked and you want to think about them again. So this is how you are going to answer the question. Now talking about the question distribution. So as we saw in the first slide, the exam is divided into two parts, 150 in the first part and 150 in the second part. If you have seen my previous videos, I have always emphasized about first six subjects like anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, patho, micro and pharmacology. Because these questions are the most important questions and they also form the, they carry the maximum weightage. So as you can see, anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, three subjects, they carry weightage of 51 marks. So that is the 1/3 of your paper one. So you understand how important these three subjects are. Also pathology, microbiology, pharmacology, they also carry around 40 marks, and forensic medicine 10. So these seven questions around 100, and the large subject and other small subject, they carry around 200 marks. But let me tell you guys, this distribution is not strictly followed. Also, there are some questions which I feel they are from physiology, but some other person would say no, they are from medicine, and the person would say no, that is from pathology. So there is always a overlap. But my opinion is that if your anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, pathology, microbiology, and pharmacology is strong, if you have revised and read them well, we'll be able to answer maximum questions. Okay. So don't worry about the scheme. So what I advise, that how should you attack a question? So there you will get 3 to 4 types of questions. The first time is one liner like this, like most common type of Caesar internet. So you know the answer or you don't know the answer. Second will be some clinical scenario. So clinical scenario will be, there will be a different type of symptoms given, different clues, and there will be the signs and there will be some lab investigations, and they will want you to know the, tell you the diagnosis. Third group is images. So there will be some x-rays, some CT scan, then some instruments or some histopathological specimens or slides. So that will be given and you will be asked that what kind of, because that is thing with the digital examination, that they can give you pictures, they can give you ECGs, they can give you x-rays. You don't have to be scared because they are very basic questions. So what I'm going to tell you that how to attempt a question. So when whenever there is a one-liner question, if you have read your notes well, if you have revised them well, it will come as a reflex. It will, like, most of the answers will come directly from the spinal level if you have revised well. So you don't have to think. Also, I'll advise, don't change the answers at the last minute, because if there are 10 questions, the answers you're going to change at the last minute, the answers are that most of the time you are going to change a right answer to a wrong answer. So don't change the answer at the last minute. And how to attack clinical question. So whenever you are being asked a clinical question, first, because it will be a huge question, so there will be a lot of data in it, so read the option first. Because what happens, most of the times they might be asking you what will be the investigation of choice. Sometimes they will be asking you what is the diagnosis or treatment or anything. So when you read the option, you don't have to waste extra time on reading options again. So when you read the option first, and then you start reading the question for clinical type of questions, then while reading each line, you know what you want to, what information you want to get from that line. So read your option first and then try to understand, try to interpret what examiner wants to know, what examiner wants to tell you. Then third kind of question is image-based questions. So I have given in my previous videos the standard books, which you should follow in your undergraduate also. But even if you have not followed, when in last 2 months, whenever you get time, you just can just scroll through the PDF and you can just see images. Because you know what happens? These pictures, these histopathology slides and specimen, usually they are taken from all the standard books. So if you have seen that, like for example, some physiology graphs will always be from Gano. Some histopathology images, they will be from the Robbins path. So if you have seen that image before, it's become easier. But even if you are not, if you know the theory, then you can interconnect. Because whenever you have an X-ray, don't try to find the pathology. Whenever you are given an X-ray or CT image, look into every detail. Try to identify the organ. So that makes the answering easy. Don't try to go and directly look for the abnormality, because options can be deceiving sometimes. Then about the exam paper, there will be 300 questions. So, and there is no negative mark. So you have to attempt all 300 questions. Don't be hero, because if you can't be hero, because if you're going to attempt to 60 or 290 questions, there is no point, because there is no negative marking and just the passing exam. So you have to attempt all 300 questions, and 5 hours is more than enough time to attempt 300 questions, because you are going to have a 150 questions in, you have to solve them in 2.5 hours. So time is not an issue when you are writing FMG exam. So whenever you are, how to think the answers. So sometimes there will be questions which you know the answer. Then there is some we call intelligent guesswork. So what you do, we use the option of excluding the options. So you read the question, you don't know what might be the answer, but you start excluding. Okay, these two might not be there. ये कुछ अलग लग रहा है, ये मैंने पढ़ा नहीं था, this not be possible. So you have to rule out. So when you exclude, then you have to select between two options. If you are able to exclude two options, then it becomes easier. There is a 50-50 chance that you would be right. So you have to use the intelligent guessing, because if the questions are from the medical background. So lot of, and nowadays the trend has changed. So a lot of questions are image-based and clinical-based. So if you are going to think, the answer is somewhere hidden inside the question. So you have to do a little bit intelligent guess. Then whenever you are answering the question, do not attempt, whenever you are answering the question, the answers which you are sure of, just mark them answer. Just they should be green. Because if you are going to visit every question, what I used to do, I'll tell you my strategy. So how I attempted my 150 questions when I wrote my 50 exam. So I started with 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I know 1, 2, 3, 4, then I would directly answer them. I will not mark them for review. even if I have a 50% confusion, then I will mark them for the review. And if I don't know the answer, then I'll just move ahead, that I'll come back and think about it again. The answer which I was sure of, I would directly answer them, because a lot of students, what they do, they will mark every question and they will read 150 questions again. So your brain is fatigued. You cannot think about the question which you really want to think about. And you unnecessarily visit the question which you already know. And there is a chance that you might change the answer because of the anxiety and panic at that moment. So answers which you are sure of, do not visit them again. Just mark them answered. Okay. And 150 questions that you will get in. So initial, what happens in a part one, which I explained, the part one is usually preclinical. So you'll get a lot of anatomy, physiology, biochemistry questions. And these are mostly one-liners. So you don't have to think much. So you should trust your gut feeling also. Whatever you have read, you have to be calm that time. Do not panic. What is important is you know the answer. So do not panic. In part two, you'll get more of a clinical-based question. So do not take it any question for granted. Think about it. Till the end, do not give up, because you have 2.5 hours. So whatever questions you are confused about, just think about it. Okay. So this is how you are going to attempt a question paper. As there is no negative marking, attempt all the questions. So guys, that's all about FMG examination. So if you have any doubts, let me know in the comment. I'll try to answer them in my next video. So I would like to tell you that I'm trying to make this video series to help all the PG aspirants, be it FMG or Indian Medical Graduates, who are finding some difficulties. So share, like, and subscribe to my channel so we can disseminate this information to the students who really need it. So guys, best wishes for your exam and keep studying well.